Myself, Dr. Yogesh Sharma from Ramgadhia College of Education, Phagwara, Punjab. Today, I would like to discuss about mathematics resource room. Most of the time, students in our schools, they are fearful from mathematics. Mathematics is such a subject that students fear from it. Most of the times, students don't like mathematics. They are uninteresting in studying mathematics. Mathematics for them is dread. Mathematics for them brings anxiety. Mathematics for them brings horrible dreams. Whatever work they do, whatever hard work they do, they usually do not get succeed. They have some kind of problems with mathematics. Their heartbeat increases during math test. But this is because mathematics is an abstract subject. This is because mathematics brings some abstract nature with it. And if we want to bring mathematics to the students, or if we want to bring students close to the subject of mathematics, we must make the abstract nature of mathematics concrete. This we can do with the help of Mathematics Resource Room. National Curriculum Framework for Secondary Education 2002, it said, to help exploration of mathematical facts through experimentation, a mathematics corner could be set up in the existing science laboratories. If we have no space, separate space for math resource room, we can set up a corner in the existing science laboratories as well. For this, existing science laboratories need to be converted into science cum mathematics laboratories. Now, what is mathematics resource room? Mathematics resource room is a place in an institution where students can get material, equipments, and other teaching aids in order to develop their skills of observation, experimentation, and inferring. There are various functions of mathematics resource room. These functions are generally given by NCTE and NCERT. Mathematics resource rooms are expected to perform the following functions. Number one, providing space and material to students for hands-on experiences with mathematics material. That is what to say. To make mathematics concrete, so we need to give them some hands-on experiences. They need to feel mathematics, and this can be done when they will do some experiments with mathematics models. Second, providing the students and teachers material and equipments for demonstration, experimentation, and other related activities. Mathematics is a science. And science is nothing without experimentation. So we need to teach mathematics through experimentation also. Mathematics resource room can help us in this regard. Number three, providing place to store as well as exhibit teaching learning material in mathematics prepared by teachers and students. Most of the times, teachers complain that we have no place to store mathematics models. Students often prepare mathematics models and then we have to dump them as we have no space to store them. If we have a proper space to store them, then we can make use of those models, those charts, year on wise. Another function of mathematics resource room is providing a place equipped with necessary resources to stimulate thinking. We need to stimulate thinking of mathematics students. We need to make mathematics students think about mathematics. We need mathematization. And for this, we need some equipments. And those equipments we can found in the mathematics resource room. Then providing a place where effective teaching learning aids can be made from ordinary, cheap and waste material. It is not necessary that we make very, very huge models वेरी कॉस्टली चार्ट्स एंड अदर मटीरियल. द थिंग इज़ वी नीड टू प्रपेयर दैम फ्रॉम ऑर्डिनरी डे टू डे मटीरियल द वेस्ट मटीरियल. दिस इज मेन असेंस ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स रिसोर्स रूम. ए स्टूडेंट टू लर्न मैथमेटिक्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ कंक्रीट ऑब्जेक्ट्स एंड टू एग्जिबिट द रिलेटेडनेस ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स विद एवरी डे लाइफ. द मैथमेटिक्स रिसोर्स रूम कैन हेल्प द इन द फंक्शन दैट स्टूडेंट्स विल लर्न मैथमेटिक्स विद कंक्रीट आस्पेक्ट्स एंड इट विल हेल्प दैम टू रिलेट मैथमेटिक्स विद आवर डे टू डे लाइफ. दिस इज़ ए मेजर ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ टीचिंग मैथमेटिक्स एट प्राइमरी स्टेज ऑल्सो. सेवंथ, वी कैन से दैट इफ स्टूडेंट टू वेरीफाई और डिस्कवर सम ज्योमेट्रिक प्रॉपर्टीज यूजिंग मॉडल्स measurements, paper cuttings, paper foldings, etc. We need to discover geometric properties that we can simply do by just simple paper cutting and simple paper folding also. Then mathematics resource room can help a student to use different tables and ready reckoners in solving some problems. Ready reckoners help us to make things simple. And with the help of tables and ready reckoners, we can solve some problems very easily. And these we can found in the mathematics resource room. A student to draw graphs and to do certain calculations using computers and calculators. It is not necessary that all the time we do oral calculations and we make no use of technology. Technology is entering in our homes. Technology is now in our hands and we need to use that technology in order to understand mathematics. And we can do lot of things on computers and calculators. One thing that we can have in our math lab is MATLAB. We can have calculators where students perform different calculations. Then the student to do some field work like surveying, finding heights, making sports fields, etc. using instruments kept in the resource room. We can make use of project method here. We can make use of laboratory methods here. We can ask students that there is a sports field, there is a badminton court, there is a volleyball court, there is a football field in our schools. Try to find what is its length, what's its breadth, what is its area, how much cost it will occur to grow a grass in it. Then the students and teachers to organize mathematics club activities, including celebration of birthdays of famous mathematicians. Mathematics club help us to make mathematics interesting. In order to students join mathematics, in order that students love mathematics, we must have a mathematics club in our schools. And the activities of those mathematics clubs can be organized in the mathematics resource rooms. The students to listen or view certain audio or video CDs relating to different mathematical concepts or topics. There are various videos and CDs available in the market and we can place those videos and CDs in the mathematics resource room. Then a student to see certain program on a computer as a part of remedial instruction or enrichment under the proper guidance of the teacher. Sometimes students who are little slow in learning mathematics or students who are very fast in learning mathematics, we are not able to give them adequate time in the normal classrooms. And for them, we can have some special education programs in the mathematics resource room. We can provide them either remedial instruction or we can provide them the enrichment if a student is very, very gifted in mathematics. The students to perform certain experiments which can be easily evaluated by the teacher. The students to do certain projects under the proper guidance of the teacher. guidance of teacher is always necessity. Mentorship of teacher is always necessity. We can't leave students alone in a mathematics resource room. We need the proper presence of teacher all the time in a mathematics resource room. Now, we need some recreation in our life also. And the students can perform some recreational activities in mathematics resource room also. A teacher to visually explain some abstract concepts by using 3D models. Mathematics is abstract, and those abstract concepts can be explained easily with the help of 3D models. A teacher to demonstrate certain concepts and patterns using charts and models. Mathematics is about patterns, and we can show the patterns in mathematics with the help of charts and models in the mathematics resource room. A teacher to demonstrate and reinforce the truth of certain algebraic identities using different models. A teacher to demonstrate the truth of various formula of area and volume of different plane and solid figures using models. A teacher to explain certain concepts using computers and calculators. We can take help of computers and calculators in teaching some concepts also. The teachers and students to consult good reference mathematics books, journals kept in a library, as well as laboratory. There must be some good books. There must be some journals available in the mathematics resource room. Then the teachers to meet and discuss important issues related to mathematics from time to time. Whenever teachers need to discuss about mathematics, whenever teachers need to discuss about the learning of students, they need some corner, they need some room, and mathematics resource room is that place. A teacher to explain certain concepts, data, graph, etc. using slides. A teacher to generate different sets of parallel tests using a computer for testing the achievement and creativity of students. Last but not the least, the budding mathematicians to take inspiration from lives, works, and anecdotes relating to great mathematicians. Now, what material we can have in a mathematics resource room? The list is very long. We will start from one by one. Number one is instrument, the mathematical instrument set. Under mathematical instrument sets, we can have ruler, set square, divider, protractor, and compasses. We can have meter scale, measuring tape, and diagonal scale. We can also have some tables in the mathematics resource room. The tables of squares, tables of square roots, cubes, cube roots, compound interest, and recurring deposits. We can also have some ready reckoners of wages, ready reckoners of interests, ready reckoners of taxes. These ready reckoners will help to solve some problems easily. Then we can have some charts and pictures also. The charts of following, involving numbers 1 to 100, even and odd demarcated with different colors. Multiples of 3 demarcated. Multiples of 5 demarcated. Primes demarcated. Multiples of 9 demarcated. Charts of units of length, area, volume along their abbreviations. Then we can have charts of magic squares, important formula, regional numerals, numerals of ancient times, and portraits of mathematicians along with anecdotes. We can have charts of magic squares like that. We can have charts of metric units expressed in the power of 10. What is Google? It is 10 raised to the power 100. What is Tera? It's 10 raised to the power 12. What's giga? It's 10 raised to the power 9. Likewise, what is hecto, deca, base unit, deci, centi, milli, micro, nano, and pico? It is 10 raised to the power minus 12, we can have chart like that in our mathematics resource room. Then we can have some mathematical games and puzzles. Make as many different codes for MCT by substituting numerical values to the letters given below. Big opt MCT. We can have many different puzzles. We can ask students to create puzzles. We can ask students to gather puzzles. And those we can have in our mathematics resource room. Then we can have number of models. We can have geo board. It can be rectangular geo board. It can be circular geo board, or it can be isometric geo board. Then we may have models for varying different identities. We can have a model for a plus b's whole square is equal to a square plus 2ab plus b square. We can have a model for a minus b square is equal to a square minus 2ab plus b square. Then we can have a model for a plus b plus c whole square. We can have a model for a square minus b square. We can have a model for like k into a plus b plus c is equal to ka plus kb plus kc. We have a rectangle whose one side is a plus b plus c and whose another side is k. The area of this is k into a plus b plus c. We divide it into three parts, a, b and c. The part a area is ka, part b rectangle is kb and part third rectangle is kc. Since the rectangle 3 has been, we get from the rectangle whose area was k into a plus b plus c, so we can say that k into a plus b plus c is equal to ka plus kb plus kc. We can have a model for a plus b whole cube is equal to a cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square is equal to b cube. The volume of this cube will be a plus b whole cube. When we will bisect this cuboid, what will we get? Its parts. And we get the volume of each and every part of this, and that will become equal to a plus b whole cube. And from here we can prove the identity a plus b whole cube is equal to a cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square plus b cube. It was like take a cube of side a of 3 units and another cube of side b is equal to 1 units. Take 3 cuboids of dimensions a into b, take 3 another cuboids of dimensions a into b. This way we can solve the identity. Similarly, we can solve the identity a cube plus b cube. We can have models of different types of triangles. We can have models of different types of quadrilaterals. We can have models of different angles, circle, sphere, hemisphere. We can have model for prism, pyramids, cylinder, cone. We can have a model for cube and cuboid. Like the model for finding surface area of geometrical figures, area of triangle, then area of trapezium. There is a trapezium, we can divide it into the three parts and we will find area of different parts. Then from there we can prove that what is area of trapezium. We can have some paper cutting also. Illustration for Pythagoras theorem. Draw right angles with squares on its sides. There is a right angle, triangle, and we draw squares on all the three sides. Subdivide the square on the larger leg as shown, that is on the larger leg. Then cut the pieces for the squares on the two legs and assemble them to cover the square on the hypotenuse. From that we will get that hypotenuse square is equal to base square plus altitude square. This can be like this also. We can also prove Pythagoras theorem by counting simple squares with models like that. Each side we construct a square, then we divide that square into further squares of one unit. We can also have illustration by Bhaskara's proof. Here we have a square inside and a larger square. The area of larger square is C square, which is equal to area of four triangles plus area of middle square, which is proves that C square is equal to B square plus A square. The area of large square is C square. The area of four triangle is 4 into 1 by half into AB. This is equal to 2AB. The area of the small square is equal to B minus A into B minus A. The area of large square equal to the area of four right triangles plus the area of the small square. So C square is equal to 2AB plus bracket B square minus 2AB plus A square. So C square is equal to B square plus A square. Therefore, the sum of squares of sides of a right triangle equals the square of the hypotenuse. Then we can have a model of hexagon. We can find sum of angles of a polygons, different polygons like that, by dividing it into the different triangles. Then we can have models of clinometer. We can have a model of stadium. We can divide the stadium in different parts. One part is semicircle. Then we join two semicircles. It will become circle, and middle part will be the rectangle. We will find areas of circle and we will find area of rectangle, and from that we can get area of that stadium also. There can be many more models also. Sum of angles of a triangle is 180 degree. Sum of angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degree. Diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other at right angle triangles, like that. Moreover, we can have other models also. Finding volume and relationship among right circular cone, a hemisphere and a right circular cylinder and of the same radii and heights, Thales theorem, surface area of spheres, etc. We can have a multimedia in our resource room. That multimedia can help students in giving demonstration, in giving seminars. We can ask students to prepare slides. We can ask students to prepare overhead projector slides. And students, we have a competition today. You have to make best slides for that. We can have some calculators also. We can organize certain competitions in among the students, that we will perform certain activities on the calculators. Then we can have a computers with the internet facilities also. We can ask students to go on Google and find different theorems. We can ask students to go on Google and find different models. Try to find different activities on that. Then we can have number of books and journals. We need very good books in mathematics that we have to include. We can have portraits of various mathematicians in our mathematics resource room. Likewise, I would like to show an activity, simple activity that we can use. Most of the times teachers complain that they have not enough time for making models. They have not enough time to perform activities, but we can do simple activities also. Here I would like to show an activity where we can find the sum of angles of a triangle is 180 degree. First of all, we will cut a triangle. Here we have a triangle. Now we will fold this triangle like that. We will fold from the half, from its upper vertex . Now open it. It will be like, there will be a crease here, and from that crease fold this vertex up to that, and now this vertex also up to that. So here you can see, now we will fold from above also. So here we can see that the three angles are like that, and we can simply say that, we can easily say that now with this, the sum of angles of a triangle is 180 degree, and this can also be used for finding area of this triangle also. This triangle has been converted into the rectangle, and from that area of this rectangle will be equal to the area of triangle. Dear students, the thing is, we must be interested in helping students learn mathematics. If we are interested in helping students learning mathematics, we will have no excuses. We will find excuses only when we are not motivated to teach. We as a teacher need to help students understand mathematics, and that can be only done when we have a good resource room with us.